Ah, Herr Morgan.
Herr Strauss.
How are you enjoying yourself here?
Well enough, I guess. And you?
Well, it turns out the pursuit of freedom is not a cheap business. Not for us, and not for some of the locals.
Shocking already.
I prefer to call it banking.
You ain't the one handing out the beatings.
No, but I am the one feeding the women and children in the camp. What choice do we have, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know. Well, come on, then. Tell me who.
Here's the list. Refinery worker turned hunter by the name of Vinton Holmes. You'll find him up in the hills north of Strawberry. Ah, an apprentice undertaker. This one working in Rose. His name was Gwen Hughes.
And how many of them do you think will be able to pay?
With enough encouragement, both of them.
Oh, hey, Arthur.
Yeah.
So, tell me, is your people, Jacobites or English lovers, Arthur?
My people were peasants. We had no time for politics.
My dad would say that no politics was politics.
That old world bullshit, it ain't got no place here.
Why? Because there ain't no judgment here. Most folks hate the Negroes, they hate the Redskins, the Jews, even us Irish. You ain't so free of politics.
I hate everyone just the same.
Well, in that case, you're gonna want what I just found for us.
What's that?
I was riding around a couple of days back. I come across this old cabin. A couple of fuckers lazing about outside all liquored up. I didn't think nothing of it. But then I come across this hunter down by the river. And he tells me they're a stick-up crew. Says they hit a train a couple of days back near Emerald Ranch. Nice fella he was, shared a bottle we did. Then I robbed the bastard blind.
You believed him?
No reason not to. If he's right, it'll be a big haul for us. I saw three of them, maybe more, but I reckon you and me, we could take them real easy.
All right. What the hell? Let's go check it out.
Them sons of bitches think they're mean. They're about to get a lesson in mean.
You just keep your cool, you hear me?
All right, let's do this. Get!
How far is this place?
Bit of a ride. Not too bad. Back up north the stretch. Not far from the state line.
All right.
Ah, nice of you to join me. Ah. catch you, just ride with me.
Got it, you.
Hard left coming up. All right, it's going to be off the road up ahead. Up here, Morgan.
I want them to hear us coming.
Here, I'll deal with them. Let's make sure we keep one of them alive to tell us where they stashed the money.
Hope you...
know what you're doing.
You're a real asshole, you know that?
Your pals here.
Okay, okay, I give up. Don't shoot. I ain't armed.
Tell us where you stash your money and we'll let you live.
Well, all right, take it easy. Behind the wall in the bedrooms. If you stick your hand between the gap.
All right, you go grab the money. We'll keep an eye on Sunshine here.
You know what? Just get the hell out of here and don't look back.
Oh.
Here we are. We got some good stuff.
Why don't you see what else you can find, Sean?
Told you we'd take him, no problem, didn't I?
You did good. Let's see what the pay is first.
Dug this up all by myself. A proper lead.
All right, all right.
You heard him, right? He said the stash was behind a loose board in the bedroom.
You find anything yet? Don't want to overstay our welcome, do we?
Hey, it's over there.
This is more like it. Good work.
Hey, what about my car? I found a place, didn't I?
All right, here. But don't forget to give the camp its share. Supplies don't appear by magic, you know.
All right, don't need the lecture again. I'll see you back at camp.
Never know what folks got stashed. There's gotta be other places out there like this.
What the devil are you looking at?
I'm sorry?
No, I'm sorry. I'm ruined. Ruined!
How so?
It's a disaster. Who wants to see a woman wrangle wild animals who doesn't have any bloody wild animals? Come to America. Margaret. Mistress of fucking danger.
Idiot.
Do you? Easy, boy. Gotta be done. Okay, boy. Let's go. Yeah. Okay, then. Easy, easy. Look here. What they done to you? Yep. Your stripes better not rub off on my pants. Whoa. Here.
Him, our zebra.
Well, you can't call him that. Boy.
Yep. Idiot. There we go.
Stripey.
Hey, mister.
Oh.
Miss.
Howdy, mister.
Did you lose a tiger?
Yeah, you found one?
Nah, I found your caravan down the way. Margaret said that you might need a hand.
Oh, you weren't wrong. That tiger's missing. I sent our best lion out to find him, and now he's missing too. It is a right old predicament.
Your lion from Timbuktu, weren't he?
From Valentine, I think. He might be more of a kind of dog than a lion, but in a certain light, a feller could never tell.
Of course. Which way'd he go?
Into them shrubs over there.
Okay.
That first set of shrubs, that's where I lost sight of them.
I got it. Thank you. inside. Back blood. To me. Shit. What's this? Found your dog. Ex-dog, ex-lion.
Hey, boy. Oh, where's the rest of them?
I think a cougar took them.
That'd be Stripey. And I always thought they got along. But
your tiger is a wild.
The other half? Really?
I'm gonna put them in your wagon. You find somewhere to hide.
Oh. Well... behind that log, then.
Okay. Grubs up. Stay down. She won't be too far away.
Come quick. I went out to find a tiger.
Cougar, you mean?
And I end up losing a lion.
Yeah, dog.
Ain't having any luck.
Well, if that's what you're dealing with, you didn't have any luck to begin with. Cougars and dogs.
Hey, it ain't what you got in this life. It's what you make of it.
Well, that's very wise of you. Especially when you're lacking zebras and tigers. Hey, keep your head down. It's coming.
Look, I really don't think she'll eat the dog. Like I said, they was friends.
Shut it.
I guess she's real hungry.
She's feral. I'm locking her in. Sorry, girl. All right. Let's go.
We got her! Okay. Drive, will you? And I'll keep an eye on her.
Sure thing.
Let's get her back to Mr. Margaret. She's still eating. I would have thought, since they was close and all.
Well, wild creatures turn on each other. Seeming friendly one minute, dinner the next. Viciousness comes easy. I mean, I should know. I've run with a few of them myself.
Is that right?
No, not really. Hey, I realize I ain't properly introduced myself.
Sally Nash.
Arthur Morgan.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Tell me, Miss Nash, how you end up in this racket?
I guess it's always been my inclination, you know? Wild beasts and the like. I met Mr. Margaret, we got to talking, and... you can probably tell, in this field, he's the ace of spades.
He's a card, all right.
It's my modest hope, one day, to be the world's second bravest woman animal wrangler.
I'd say you got that sewn up and then some.
You think? I hope so. Top five, at least. Depends on how many more fellers throw their hat in the ring.
Maybe one of these days, the best female for the job will actually be a female.
Oh, I don't know if that'll ever happen. We lost the main road around here when the dust was up. Be careful, you might get wrecked too.
Okay. You know the only thing to do in a dust storm is wait it out?
Mr. Margaret's a lot of things, but best female navigator ain't one of them.
Imagine you're right about that.
We was tearing around here, looking for any kind of landmark, when over we go. Whole caravan toppled. Found each other and some shelter, but... when the wind died down, the animals was gone.
And now they're back. Some of them, at least.
Thanks to you.
You would have managed it yourself. I just helped you along.
If you ever want to get in the sideshow business, I'm sure there'd be a place for a fellow like you.
I'll leave the professional...
Aha! I see you found each other. Here and fix me a gin.
Come on, boy.
holding it. Hold yours!
What's the ruckus, boys?
Get back! We got a cursed creature in here!
Oh, yeah?
It's as big as a mule and as mean as a hellcat.
It looked like a lion to me.
That's a dog in there.
A dog?
Now, if you'll excuse me, step aside.
What?
I said step aside. Yeah, boy.
Didn't look like no dog.
Come here, boy. Let's go home.
Shot the thing! Is it dead? I pray that thing's a goner. Whoever owned that beast got some answering to do.
Let's go, boy.
Yep.
up. Yep. Back to work, boy.
Here my whole life.
Your life? This is what you call this? This ain't no life. We got work. We are earning money. That's more than most.
Barely enough to...
Now, this is ridiculous. I'm out of here.
Oh. We'll talk about this later when we ain't being rudely interrupted.
Come on, mister. She just wants what's best for you two.
Hey, hey, watch yourself. Damn it all! Head in the clouds, that one.
It's unbelievable. If you ain't a Gray or a Braithwaite, you ain't nothing. Might as well be a worm in this town. I'm sorry you had to see me like this, mister. It ain't becoming.
He'll come around once he's settled.
He just won't open his eyes and see what's in front of him. Oh!
All right, Dan. Hope you two figure it out. You idiot. Let's get. Yep. Here. Okay, boy.
You can come in, but you have a problem. How about we talk it through this time? You?
I knew today was gonna be a bad day. Okay, better not be stolen, all right?
Guess that's done.
You think about laying hands on me again, it's gonna end bloody for you. What can I do for you, huh?
Okay, now let me see.
Chose well. So, you're back. All right, what do you want? Huh? No matter to me. Yeah!
Still don't look quite right. Never gonna get the hang of this. You want a fitting?
Gwen Hughes, start picking out a box for yourself if you don't got that money you owe Leopold Strauss.
I need more time.
Doesn't everybody? That casket for you? Or you want another?
Wait. I can get it for you. But, come with me to the churchyard. And stay close. Hmm?
All right.
Oh, this ain't right. I'll get you your money, but, well, you'll see.
What ain't right is borrowing money you can't pay back.
I guess you're correct, but this, it ain't exactly right, what we're doing. Stay close to me now.
You ain't the first to put his hand in the collection box, and you won't be the last. Rest a little easier knowing church has been taking more than they need off poor folks since time began.
Well, like I said, well, the morality of the matter is a little more confusing than that.
Okay, you head on in the church, I'll keep watch.
Well, it ain't in there. It's under here. I'm digging up Mrs. Claypole.
Jesus!
Well, she got a bunch of jewels in there that she don't need. Oh, damn it. There's a bunch of people here. Oh, I got it. Look, you clear them off, and I'll wait right around here. But don't hurt nobody. We don't want no fuss.
Don't be shy.
Just my auntie?
Your auntie's long past.
You two might want to find somewhere a little more private.
We was fine until you got here, mister. Good day now.
Get out of here, kids. Move!
Come on. I knew we shouldn't have been here.
You missed your chance, boy!
Ma'am, would you mind clearing out of here for some maintenance work?
Oh, gladly. It's about time this place got cleaned up.
It's all clear.
All right. Now go watch the gate. I'll get to this, exhumation.
I'm sorry, ma'am. The church grounds are closed for maintenance work.
Well, it's about time, too. The place was in need of some care and attention.
Thanks.
Sure would.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
Hey, look, we're closed for some, excavation work. Would you mind?
No, I ain't gonna mind you at all. You carry on with your business, we'll carry on with ours. This fella. Oof.
Damn choir boy.
Get the hell out of this churchyard! Are you boys gonna need yourselves a preacher?
You hear this fella?
I heard him all right.
We're gonna lick you back! You gonna get it!
Shit. Hope this hole's dug.
Well, here's your payment. Oh, forgive me, Mrs. Claypole.
What you find?
But she had a brooch here. It looks like diamonds.
Well, this'll do. Now get out of here before someone sees you.
Can't believe it's come to this. All right, well, I'm out of here.
That's more than clear what I owe you.
What can I do for you?
That snake was pure evil, it was.
Oh, yeah?
This word has some evil spirits in it.
Hola.
It's a damn snake. That kind of talk will land you in hell. You don't pretend otherwise.
Keep talking like this, you ain't gonna end up nowhere pleasant, neither.
Don't mock me. I have been through something.
Thanks for your help.
Oh, shit.
Strange times.
Don't you try to pull anything funny again. I will come back to haunt you.
All right, what do you have for me?
Right out. Mm-hmm. Just the way it goes.
Y'all are a bunch of flannel mouth liars.
Mr. Harper was selling whiskey last week. Said it was for medical purposes only.
Yeah, I heard.
I swear, I ain't recognize no one around here no more. Folks come to me for crafted trinkets and such. You got the right ingredients, I can take a look. Fine, fine. Really? You won't regret it. Go anywhere, anywhere. You won't find better prices.
God hates us.
Well,
I won't ask too many questions about its previous ownership.
Don't
Don't you tell no one, you hear?
Yep.
Holy hell.
Can I help you?
I'll tell you. That snake was...
Oh, oh, oh. Hey, hey, Brad, remember me? Yeah.
Of course, of course. Oh. And here is my dear friend, Arthur Callahan. Boy is a hunter. Boy is a... Liquor never dulled a good man's senses. Arthur, you ride with the deputy. Bill and I will follow.
Climb on up.
Let's go.
Archibald?
How are you?
Pretty good.
And your friend is behaving himself?
Oh, yes. I think he's learned his lesson.
Congratulations on becoming a temporarily deputized citizen of Scarlet Meadows County. Most towns just get bounty hunters to do their dirty work these days, but Sheriff Gray believes the law should keep the law. Now, I'm sure I don't need to remind you, there's a chain of command here.
There is?
Dang straight there is. This is a dangerous business, but follow my lead and you'll be just fine.
Sure. Hey! Archibald wants to remind us he's in charge here.
Of course!
Who else would be?
But you were a big help with them Anderson boys, and I put in a very good word with the sheriff on your behalf.
We appreciate that.
We rounded up the others soon after. I'm pushing for the rope myself, but that's by the by.
So, these moonshiners?
Not just any moonshiners. Braithwaites. I told you about the Braithwaites?
Pretty sure you did.
Old Cotton family had a fortune at one point until, well, a few changes in the labor laws. Now they're dealing in moonshine. We found their stills hidden all over Lemoyne. Quick as we destroy one, another one pops up. You could call it a pitiful fall from grace, if they had any grace to start with.
I have no time for tax dodgers.
Not to mention the fact that Catherine Braithwaite has a rather expensive interest in thoroughbred horses to maintain.
But I heard something about it being gold these families were fighting over.
Well, that's the rumor. But the Greys and the Braithwaites think the other stole a fortune from them. But it happened so long ago, I don't know for sure if it's true.
Must be tough being rich, huh?
So I imagine.
That badge rather suits you, Mr. W.
Yes. I thought so, too.
Does it feel good to be back at it, serving your country?
I wouldn't go that far.
Whoa! Whoa! Hold up! You see that wagon?
These damn flies! I swear they got it in for me.
You could try washing once in a while.
That don't look good. Oh.
Come on, mister.
Keep your eyes open. No. This must have happened recently.
Hey, come have a look at this.
Look. Suit and tie. One bullet clean through the forehead. Well, my money says this is the handiwork of a gang called the Lemoyne Raiders.
Yeah, I've run into them.
Let's see if we've got any identification. Okay. We should get going. I'll send someone over here later to clean this up. Mind taking the reins? I want to have a look at these papers.
Sure.
I'll direct you. Okay. Frederick Mitchell, Lemoyne State legislator. Poor feller.
Hey, not so fast!
Go right at the crossroads.
Yep. Not the nicest fellers in my experience.
Oh, and I know the Braithwaites are in business with them. No shame. Bear right again here. Trash begets trash, my Uncle Reginald used to say. He had a few stories, let me tell you. Town preacher and town sheriff.
Whoa, take it easy.
But drink a sailor under the table before breakfast. He had one tiny hand, like a child's, on the end of a grown man's arm. But anyway, this tells you what kind of people the Braithwaites are, selling moonshine to murderers. Here we are. So what was I saying?
Something about the Braithwaites, I think.
Even saying that word makes me sick.
We need to get moving now, Deputy. What are you waiting for? Anyone we find here, we bring in alive, understood? Round them up, and take this operation down for good. Come on. Let's see what we're dealing with.
See? See? What did I tell you, boys? What did I say? I said this place was crawling with vermin, and we just found ourselves the rat's nest par excellence, as they say in Paris. My aunt, she went to Paris back in 78.
I'll handle this.
Well, I see it.
Actually, let my friend here decide. He doesn't have your fine way with words, but he is definitely the man for the job.
Let's split up. Arthur and Bill, me and Archibald.
Bill, this way.
Remember what he said. We... See one by the bridge over there? I saw another one guarding the still. I'll get this feller trussed up.
Thank you.
Good work, gentlemen. I think that's it. Well, what do we do now?
We better destroy all this. Any of your boys can handle explosives?
Sure. Anyone but him.
Oh, so, I think you're real funny, don't you? Tell me
about that. That is the last time I'll mention it, I swear. Tell me you're almost done, Arthur.
Sure. Just a second. That is the last time I'll mention it, I swear.
Bitches come from!
The Raiders make the law around here.
Sorry, boys. We're putting you out of business. We're taking blood for every drop of that shine.
Got some trees on there for us.
Thank you.
Fine by me. Yes! Show it to Hosea. I'm sure he can find a use for it. Bit of trouble back there, Arthur? They're always. From what they was yelling, I think they were the buyers. Why are you doing that? Old Archibald didn't ask too many questions, so neither should we. I ain't planning to. That was worth the effort, though. Deputized and hiding in plain sight. These lawmen. These two families. I mean, I really think we can play this from all sides. It's got Hosea written all over it.
This is starting to sound like the Young Dutch again.
What do you mean, Young Dutch? I'm as strong as I have ever been. Hey, you know what? Why don't I race you back?
Okay, you're on.
That's the spirit. Okay, on my word. Set, go! You never were much of a rider.
We'll see about that.
Never knew you were quite so good at running away.
Thank you.
Susan.
Hey, Arthur.
Mr. Renshaw.
Arthur.
You going fishing?
Yes.
Or running on.
All right, then. Grab your horse and let's go.
Okay, boy.
Hello, Glenn.
Okay, follow me. I know a great little fishing spot along the beach. Who'd have thought it? Wasn't that long ago I was tied to the back of your horse while begging for mercy. Now we're off fishing together.
How do you know I ain't just looking for a good place to drown you?
Because I saved your life, Arthur.
You keep saying that. But I save your life every day I don't kill you. So we are more than even on that front.
Come on, you don't mean that.
You better believe I mean it. Now, where's this spot?
Not much further. This is the place. Some beautiful smallmouth here. Anyway, you were saying?
Bass?
Sure. This strip of shore looks perfect. Pick a spot. Seeing lots of bluegill and bass over here. Bait with worms or crickets if you got them. Otherwise, maybe some bread or cheese.
You getting many bites there, O'Driscoll?
I ain't an O'Driscoll. I told you fellas 100 times. I'd only been with them a couple of months. I was just a runner, helping out with the horses mainly. Bottom rung of the ladder.
And to think that was the high point of your career.
Comb goes through men like cigars. They ain't like you folks. You barely knew my name. I'm more Kieran Vanderlyn than Kieran O'Driscoll at this point. Honest to God. Mostly I'm Kieran Duffy.
I hate to break it to you, but I ain't sure Kieran Vanderlyn is gonna stick.
What in the world? Arthur, are you seeing this? The feller's naked as a jaybird.
Is that why you like this spot?
My lord, there's somebody needs to go to confession.
Hey, what's the lie?
Oh, hey! I nearly gulped down a minnow. Sorry, fellas. Didn't see you there. Why don't you take a break? Come on in. The water's wonderful.
I reckon we'll leave you to it. Just don't scare all the fish.
Oh, just so you fellas know, there's some real big ones over that way, like this. Well, I better keep the blood pumping. Hope you gents catch something.
Yeah? Maybe we'll take a look. Thanks.
I know where that is. Come on, let's go.
Come on, let's go.
Hey, wait up! Okay.
Are you coming then? I think this is the place that naked fella was talking about. Did you see that amazing bluegill?
Sure. That got you real excited, huh?
Come on, Arthur. Let's walk down to the beach. I hope we land this monster.
Uh-huh.
It ain't easy to catch a fish like that with bread and cheese, but you never know. You might get lucky.
Guess we'll see.
What are you waiting for? Get after that bluegill, Arthur.
Thank you.
So who taught you how to fish?
My pappy, mostly. I lost my mammy and pappy when I was young to cholera.
Your mammy?
Like I said, I was real young. After that, I was on my own pretty much, but I knew horses and fishing.
Well, just think now, you'll never be alone again.
You got it. That has got to be the one, right?
It might be. Putting up one hell of a fight.
Nice catch, but that's not the big one we saw.
See? Look at this. Life ain't so bad. At least you ain't tied to a tree.
I'm still a prisoner, Arthur. I can't step outside camp by myself for a second without being terrified one of Combs' boys gonna come pick me up. When I'm in camp, I got Bill and Sadie whispering in my ear all the time how they're gonna kill me in my sleep. It's like living in a nightmare.
Christ. If I'd known you were gonna moan this much, I'd have never said yes to this.
I don't think we have much chance. We need better bait. You might want to see if the stores around here sell anything better. I think I'm gonna head back to camp, Arthur, if that's okay.
Sure. Go on, I'll see you later.
Boy.
You busy, Arthur?
Not too busy. Why?
I heard about a house.
Could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. A family local boogeyman, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
Well, so these boys thought they were sitting on a lot of cash. They're highway robbers, kidnappers, apparently. They're well hidden in the woods.
That sounds pretty dubious.
Of course. Yeah, it's dubious, but there ain't much risk of getting caught.
Okay, then. Let's go take a look.
Exactly. Just take a look.
It's up north, on the other side of the river from Valentine. Best way there is through Cumberland Falls, though. You know it?
Sure, more or less.
Mount up, come on.
All right, boy. Yeah.
Careful.
Okay, we're pretty close now. Let's stop and go on foot from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me. There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, his family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you?
No. Big place, right? Binoculars.
Well, there's a pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
Stash could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there.
I ain't sure about this. Hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Mel's right, no more yickety.
But why is me every time hunting the shrinking pig?
Because you use Callow as a pup, don't you?
Oh, Callow? You's guggling the girls at the market. No work to pride.
Come on, let's hide behind the shed. See if we can hear what they're saying.
Shut your gulp or new, don't you? Half the years and I'll be munching drool from the horses. Maybe you's hunt a pig this time once, Mal. Creepers fit. Don't score notions in the dippy Plymouth head.
Just stay quiet. Be quiet.
What the heck was that?
In torture!
Nature's a pop! Defend yours, don't ya?
Damn it, Arthur! You went too soon!
I decided to improvise!
Thank you.
What are we doing, Javier?
Okay. You take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, and then you jump him, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
You can't be stepped.
Nature's upon us. Defend.
Damn it, Arthur! You went too soon.
I decided to improvise.
We got at least one in the cabin. At the window.
Oh,
Jesus!
Well, look what we have here.
Giddy up.
Good to see you again, partner. What can I do for you? Good. Ain't no trace of rust on that as far as I can see. Yeah, beautiful condition. Keep it up.
You know what?
Bet you could use some rifling on this thing.
Dangerous.
Essential, I reckon. You keep treating that like your own child, all right? Good on you. Good. Ain't no trace of rust on that as far as I can see.
You know what? I bet I can make this piece work a lot better for you. Bolts, triggers, parts, back here.
You keep treating that like your own child, all right? Good on you.
Thanks, partner.
I got real bad nerves. I can't work. Yeah. Can you give me some money? I just want to get a drink. I'm parched.
Partner?
Hey, buddy. Hey, mister. Mister. I never learned your name. I never did. You're like a brother, but I didn't learn your name. And I said to myself, Mickey, you never learned that fella's name. Now, you'll never see him again. And you'll be sad, like when your puppy passed, because you slept on it. What's your name, mister?
Arthur.
Arthur? My uncle's name was Arthur. Uncle? Arthur, we called him, on account of his name. It's a fine name. A strong name. Like a king. You could be my king, Mr. Arthur. Yes, you could.
With this son of a bitch. Take him out, boys.
Appreciate you stepping in there. Those bastards been turning the screw on me from day one, saying I gotta pay them protection money. I told them where to stick it, and well, I guess you just saw how that panned out.
Thank you.
Easy, boy. You're okay. Yeah, that's better, boy. There you go, boy. Let's go, boy.
Yep.
Shut up that pretty mouth, or I'll... You just had to get...
This could get bumpy.
What is wrong with you all?
die.
Yep.
What can I do for you?
Get your paper.
How's yourself?
I ain't moving!
Sorry.
Well, there's a familiar face. Take a look, if you will. All right, what do you have now?
Thank you for your help.
Read it. Here you go.
Now just hold on there. Right. I know you're damn
what nice.
I don't
come
like
on,
this.
None of this, all right?
For the love of God!
Go, go, go!
You damnation!
You know what he's done? Now end him!
No, don't!
Shit!
Thank you.
Get rid of him! Now! You'll be sorry for this! God damn it!
Son of a bitch!
Okay, boy.
Yeah.
Yep.
Quinn Holmes?
I didn't expect to run into no one out here.
Funny how far a man's debts will follow him. You got some money for me, boy? I seen your name in our ledger.
You're with the German? Look, I got it for you. It's just, I don't got it yet. It's up in them hills.
You panning for
it? Hunting it. I tracked this cougar. It's rare. Lily white coat. The pelt will more than cover what I owe.
If I'm skinning anything, I'm skinning you, boy.
Please, I'm out of work. It's the only way you'll get paid, and all the hard work's already done.
Fine. Move.
We'll, need our horses. It's, quite a trip.
Yeah.
You got your mount? This den's a ways, so, mount up.
All right, drive, boy. Let's get where we're going. Drive!
Okay, follow me.
Drive!
I'm driving.
Make me come out here, make me chase all over this goddamn mountain.
Hey, you knew it was a risk.
I didn't know nothing. Your name's all I knew.
Well, the German-speaking fella then, Mr. Strauss. He knew my work situation was...
on your head, outlaw.
All right, drive, boy. Let's get where we're going. Drive!
Okay, follow me.
Drive!
I'm driving.
Make me come out here, make me chase all over this goddamn mountain.
Hey, you knew it was a risk.
I didn't know nothing. Your name's all I knew.
Well, the German-speaking fella then, Mr. Strauss, he knew my work situation was precarious, that this whole thing was a risky venture.
Wait, risky? Am I at risk now? Are you threatening me, Winton Holmes?
I ain't. No, certainly not. Sir, I'm merely stating, a man without a job, with limited prospects, at those rates, repayment was by no means guaranteed. I said I'd do my best, and I did.
You're continuing to annoy me.
We're going right here, up the stream.
Hey, how about this then? I guarantee repayment, because I'm gonna get that money out of you. If I gotta squeeze you like a lemon, it's coming out.
Yeah, of course. We're onto it now, okay? We're onto it now. The cash is in that cougar, mister. Sure as pumpkins ain't cauliflowers, the cash is in that cougar.
It better be, or I'll turn you into a goddamn cauliflower.
Up here. We ain't too far now. What I know about cats, this one's rare as hen's teeth. I mean, you ever seen an alabaster wildcat?
Big thing about cougars is they see you, not the other way around.
That may be, but you'd see this one. I've been hunting with my pa. Shot all kinds of cats. Never one like this. In another life, I'd have sought my fortune outdoors, not in the hot, stinking belly of a tar pit.
I ain't interested in your regrets or your life story, Mr. Holmes. Just your damn money. Drive.
is it. Her den. We should leave the horses.
Show me.
You'll see her soon. Quiet now. Won't be able to miss her shining in the dark. You hear that? There's a cougar in here. And I bet she's white as virgin cotton. The tunnel diverges up here. I'll take the left, you go right, and we'll see if we don't converge down a ways. And look out for her.
Yeah, yeah. There's a corpse down here. An old one. Winton Holmes? Don't mess around with me, boy. Another body. There's a corpse down here. An old one. Don't mess around with me, boy. Another body. How much is this cougar eat? Idiot.
Holmes? Wenton Holmes? There's a corpse down here. An old one. Don't mess around with me, boy. Another body. How much does this cougar eat? She got it. Crap. Damn. Dead deader. It's white. Better be rare. Get out of here, horse. Your man ain't coming. Easy there. Yep. Yep.
Looking to sell your wares or buy some of the finest meat to ever grace this town?
Thank you.
Blood in the streets of Valentine. Read all about it.
Welcome to Strawberry. Welcome. Welcome to our city.
You ain't a tourist, so I'm guessing you're a bounty hunter. Posters usually go up on that wall there. Up in the Big Valley Mountains.
Yep.
Ah, senor, I think maybe we see the last time was luck, huh?
I'm feeling good today, Wei. What do you say about upping the ante this time? Make it interesting.
bounty hunt, son of a bitch! Damn you! Damn this! Here. Okay,
you shot
boy.
Me. You didn't even have a decency to do it right. You duel a man and you ought to put him down. Not knock him out and tie him up. You got no decency, bounty hunter.
Strawberry. You shot me. You didn't even have a decency to do it right.
A man with a bullet in him, you talk a lot.
Got me in my younger days. I would have put one in the middle of your eyes before you
take a nap, old man. Now the fun starts.
I wish you killed me back there. A real man would have killed me. A real man wouldn't tie me like this. A real man wouldn't take me in. Don't deserve this. I deserve to go out with some damn honor. I live by the
gun. That's Big Josh, all right.
Hey, he looks heavy. Can we take that bounty off of you?
I can manage him fine.
turning back. I guess I'm all yours. You make me sick.
I don't need to hear it, sir. Here we are. Strawberry. I hear the cells here are really comfortable.
You trying to be winsome, bounty hunter?
Always. I'm a regular charmer. Now come on. Got Brown here.
Ah, Mr. Brown.
Come on now.
Make him comfortable downstairs.
Lock me up. Forget about me. Now, leave me to my peace.
Pay's right here. He make you work for it?
He dueled me, so I'd say that's a yes.
Lucky you're still here.
Lucky? That ain't what I call it. Honest of you.
Hey, no more posters going up here for a while. Mayor don't like the way it looks. We are a tourist.